you know, it's a bit of our attitude.
We talk about the attitude of gratitude.
Yeah, because we're being thankful. And, you know, for me, it just comes down to a choice. We wake up in the morning. God has given us breath.
And rest.
And rest. And we're so, you know, I'm so thankful after having traveled a lot of this world that I live in a country where I can have free speech. I have clean water that comes out of my tap. Mm. I have hot water that comes out to bathe and cleanse my body. Just that in itself, what a great way to start the day. I look out, I live on the river in Blackville, I have a big glass window, and I look out there and I say, I'm so thankful. The sun may or may not be shining, but I'm thankful that I'm able to do that. Yeah. That I'm a woman living in a country that's not oppressed.
Yeah.
So when we wake up in the morning, we already have tons to be thankful about, but then we have that choice. We can take 2 minutes lying in bed. We can say, ah, I'm here today. I'm breathing. I'm in a bed. I'm not sleeping on straw or on the floor. And then when we get up, we can choose, this is going to be a wonderful day, or I got to go into that terrible job. Oh, this is it. You know, the roads are bad. It's snowing outside. It's raining outside. And the way that we start that day, whether we display gratitude or whether we start to complain from day one, that's going to shape that next 24 hours. And the one thing I learned too as I get older, because I'm getting older, John. Do you know how old I am?
So I'll be, you don't look any older than the first day I met.
So I'll be 48 on my birthday. And in 2 weeks' time. But as I get a little bit older, you know, because when you're younger, you keep thinking about what you're going to do later in life and all these sorts of things. But actually, as I get older now, I'm just grateful for every day. I'm grateful that I have 24 hours to live on this planet, or maybe it's not 24. But I think about when I wake up, how can I serve? How can I help others? How can I leave my house in a state of positivity? That's what I think going out the door. When I get to the hospital, if I'm doing an emerge shift, I stand outside the ER doors, the trauma bay doors, I take a minute, I close my eyes, and say, God bless everyone that comes in here today.
Praise the Lord.
You know, may there be, I know that there will be trauma that will come through, but I say, give us strength, give us guidance. Sometimes I'll ask for the nurses, for the caregivers, you know, to give us guidance for what might be put in front of us every day.
Yeah.
I used to, when I was younger, you know, sometimes I'd be going to the hospital and I would be complaining, because we all like to complain, right?
It's easy.
It's so easy. But where does complaining get us?
Right.
But if we can make that shift, what's going to come out of my mouth, or what's that thought going to be in my head? What is that choice that I'm going to make? What is the attitude that I'm going to take? And I take an attitude of love. I take an attitude of compassion, an attitude of caring. It's taken me a while to get there, and it's taken me my own personal, you know, life, you know, my own traumas that
your
I've been
own
through.
Journey, yeah.
But it's a choice every day that yeah. we have. And for me, it's a much more wonderful way to start my day when I can go out the door with those principles behind me.